Harper Audio presents Stick With It, a scientifically proven process for changing your life for good by Sean D. Young. Read by Roger Wayne. Introduction. People have trouble making lasting changes. They quit nutrition plans, don't adhere to medication regimens, and can't keep New Year's resolutions to lose weight or stop procrastinating. The advice offered up by recent bestsellers, Charles Duhigg's The Power of Habit and Gretchen Rubin's Better Than Before, insist that the secret to success in both your personal and business lives is to develop good habits. Yet they base this on just one study, suggesting that habits account for 40% of behaviors in life and work. So, what are we supposed to do about the other 60% of our behaviors? Conventional wisdom also fails to solve the problem. It tells you the answer is to change who you are. If you want to stick with your fitness goals, learn to love exercising like Richard Simmons. To be a successful entrepreneur, become a creative genius like Steve Jobs. If you want to be a good salesperson, morph into a social butterfly like Mary Kay Ash. And the list goes on of people we're told to become like. Changing your character is easier said than done. Every individual has a core personality that doesn't change much throughout life. Fortunately, you don't need to change who you are as a person to make change last. You just need to understand the science behind lasting change and how to create a process that fits who you are. That's what this book delivers. Over the past 15 years, working with some of the top minds in science, I have identified the 7 psychological forces that undergird lasting behavior change in any context. I'm a professor of family medicine at UCLA and the executive director of the UCLA Center for Digital Behavior and the University of California Institute for Prediction Technology, UCLA. My research has received more than $10 million of funding from organizations such as the National Institutes of Health, NIH, corporations like Facebook and Intel, as well as leading hospitals and foundations. Participants in our research studies have made lasting changes in how they eat, sleep, exercise, and manage medication and chronic pain. As a result of our behavior change work, participants have been able to avoid contracting diseases like HIV, or have sought out medical treatment to save their lives. I've developed interventions to help thousands of people change their health behaviors. I've also helped dozens of startups and companies change behaviors related to their businesses. My approach is similar to what social psychologist Robert Cialdini did in Influence, Science and Practice, one of the most successful business books of all time. Cialdini reviewed 3 decades of research, integrated it with his own field work, and distilled it into a set of universal principles. Like Cialdini's principles, my forces are additive. Using one may be effective, but using 2, 3, or more will be even more effective. By using the methods I describe in this book, I have repeatedly achieved almost a 300% increase in lasting change for both individuals and groups. This means that people who used these methods were nearly 3 times as likely to change their behavior as people who did not. You can harness the forces I present here in your personal life or your business. They transformed the life of Josh Nava, who hated never being able to follow through on projects, whether a daily assignment for school or a book he wanted to complete for pleasure, and who is now a successful business owner who sticks with his work and hobbies. They transformed the life of Rishi Desai, so anxious and shy that he couldn't talk to a stranger, now a successful doctor and creator of the world-renowned Khan Academy medical school curriculum. And they were used by Joseph Coulomb to help Trader Joe's go down in history as a company that effectively made lasting changes in consumer grocery buying behavior. Stick With It offers scientifically proven ideas that will help you achieve your goals, no matter how big or how small, by applying them to your life and work as they fit your needs. Chapter 1. The Science of Lasting Change. Hellhole Bend is a deep gorge in the Grand Canyon, smack in the middle of Navajo country. Despite its name, it's ravishingly beautiful, with majestic pink, brown, white, and gold-colored rock formations rising above the Little Colorado River. But Nick Walenda isn't enjoying the view. He's holding his breath as he balances on top of a wire as wide as one of his toes. The wire is held taut between 2 rocky promontories, and is the only thing between Nick and the hard ground, 1,500 feet below. The wind is gusting at 30 miles an hour. That's enough to snap tree limbs and cause telephone lines to whistle. It's certainly enough to make Nick's legs shake. Nick is attempting to walk more than a quarter of a mile across the Grand Canyon under these less than ideal conditions. He concentrates on breathing. In, out, in, out. Nick refused to wear a safety harness or to spread a safety net below him. His only prop is a 30-foot-long, 43-pound balancing pole that he holds at a precise 90-degree angle to his body. Nick knows that the stakes are as high as they can get. Numerous family members have died or been paralyzed attempting stunts similar to this. Born into a family of circus performers brought to the United States from Germany in 1936 by the Ringling Bros and Barnum and Bailey Circus, Nick can look back on generations of acclaimed tightrope walkers, including his father and grandfather. In 1978, Nick's great-grandfather, Carl Willenda, arguably the most talented high-wire artist in the family, fell and died during a tightrope performance, much like Nick's current one. With extraordinary concentration, Nick picks up his right foot and edges it forward until it is positioned directly in front of his left foot. Step 13, done. 1,384 more to go. He tries to block the background noise and to ignore the reminders from the loudspeaker below that 13 million viewers are tuned into the Discovery Channel from around the globe to view this stunt live. They can hear him praying out loud through the headset and microphone he's wearing. "Dear Jesus," Nick whispers. He knows a certain number of observers, it's inevitable, are hoping he'll fail. For the drama. For the spectacle. "I was there when..." Nick pushes that thought from his head. He tries not to remember that his wife and his three kids, Yanni, Amadeus, and Evita, are watching below. He does remember being 12 years old and emphatically telling a reporter that he would not follow in the footsteps of his family. Never, ever would he become a high-wire artist. "It's just not worth it," he'd said. What made Nick change his mind? And more incredibly, how had he managed to stick with his training over the years despite daily reminders that his chosen vocation could kill him at any moment? Although Nick might not have the answer to that question, scientists do. And although Nick's story might not seem to have much relevance for you personally, stay tuned. You'll soon see that you have more in common with him than you thought. According to current science, Nick Willenda's path through life was actually quite predictable. Although not aware of it, Nick had intuitively done everything right to stick with it and succeed with a plan of action. By the way, Nick's walk across the Grand Canyon was successful. Next on his list, walking across the 1,200-foot-wide Tallulah Gorge, Georgia, while making time for three headstands on the wire. Recent research shows that seven psychological forces support the ability of people to stick with their plans, in both life and work. The more of these forces people incorporate in their behaviors, the more likely they are to stick with something until they reach a goal. Nick harnessed all seven during his training. This new science is also capable of helping millions around the world. 40% of dieters quit within 1 week, and more than 50% end up weighing more than they did before they started their diets. Businesses shut down because they can't get customers to keep buying their products or services. Health departments and health insurance companies fail because they can't get people to take their meds or change their lifestyle or otherwise competently manage their health. These failures cost society hundreds of billions of dollars a year. On the surface, these may seem like completely different problems with completely different causes. After all, don't people have very different motivations for failing to achieve personal goals like daily exercise than for ceasing to buy a particular brand of cereal or to stop using a certain mobile app? Yes, but no. Personal resolutions might fail and product sales may flounder for different reasons, but the problem at their core is the same. People have stopped doing something. If we know the psychology behind how to get people to stick with things, we can address all of these challenges. So how do you get people to keep doing things? Conventional wisdom comes down to change your personality. Become like those people with extraordinary willpower. Develop your presence or fire yourself up to want something so passionately that you will overcome all difficulties in your path. This kind of advice attempts to change the person, not their process. But different people are, well, different. Every person has a core personality. This personality doesn't change much throughout life. Fortunately, you don't need to change who you are to make lasting changes. You just need to understand the science behind change and create a process that fits who you are. That's what this book delivers. The seven forces behind lasting change, and how to use my framework, called SCIENCE, which stands for stepladders, community, important, easy, neurohacks, captivating, ingrained, to adapt them to meet your particular needs. Nick Walenda harnessed all seven of these forces to keep him disciplined and on track with his training year after year so he could perform death-defying tightrope acts. But most people have more modest goals. While Nick's story is thrilling, most people have more mundane things they're trying to stick with. Most of us aren't trying to stay motivated to walk across skyscrapers like a superhero. For most of us, just remembering to floss our teeth or rubber-tip our gums every day next week is a big feat. So let's step back and recalibrate from Nick's story to a more typical story, like that of suburban dad Josh Nava. Josh Nava hated the fact that he never followed through. As a student, he couldn't get himself to do his homework even when he liked the topic. In later years, he collected shelves full of books but would drop one book midway to start reading a new one. Married with two children, he now found it harder than ever to stick with things. He had gone through a string of jobs and struggled to find balance between his wife, kids, and work. Having attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, ADHD, didn't help. He was easily distracted, and even small tasks like sending an email would take more than an hour. Josh would set his mind to do something and inevitably fail to follow through. He asked himself, "How do I get myself to keep doing things I want to do when I keep getting in my own way?" Was there anything that could help him change? How about a wooden spoon? Josh had an idea. What if he started simply focusing on something small? What if he tried doing this small thing every day, no matter what else was going on in his life? Josh had always enjoyed crafting things like chairs and cutlery. So, in 2014, he created an Instagram account called @365spoons. Instagram is an online platform where people share photos and videos with friends. His plan? To craft a different wooden spoon every day and share it online with whoever wanted to follow him. His goal was to do it for a full year, 365 days, and to stick to it, even if he only ended up with a handful of followers. He knew from bitter experience that he'd tried things before and would quit as soon as the novelty wore off. But this time, he planned to do it differently. Each day, Josh crafted a wooden spoon from recycled or unwanted materials and posted the image with a caption to Instagram. He also shared that with this project, he was trying to solve the problem of always being a quitter. Within weeks, Josh gained hundreds of followers wanting to hear about his struggle to stick with a hobby, to see images of the beautiful spoons he had created, and to encourage him to keep going. All that was good for Josh, but as he had anticipated, after a month, the excitement of the project wore off. It became a chore. The last thing he wanted to do after a long day at work and spending time with his family was to complete a new spoon design. Josh was in a familiar headspace and ready to quit. But his Instagram followers wouldn't let him. After he expressed his fatigue and discouragement, he was barraged with encouragement. "I would not be able to maintain this project for a month, and I am single with no kids. I have a huge respect for your commitment. You are an inspiration," wrote one fan. "You're speaking my language, brother. Your persistence in this, knowing we have similar struggles, is so impressive. So proud of you," wrote another. And another commented, "You have inspired me. One collage a week for this year I'm going to do." Their words of encouragement kept Josh going. He not only completed his goal of creating a new spoon every day for the year, but also accumulated an active Instagram following too. Josh said he had come to an important realization for the first time in his life. "I learned that I was capable. It had just been buried. Like putting a stake in the ground, I realized I could follow through. It wasn't about creating spoons. It was about confronting myself on an important issue. To look back and see that pile of spoons growing was meaningful." Along the way, Josh tapped five of the seven forces of lasting change. Not incidentally, he now has a successful custom woodworking business called Suburban Palette, where he sells spoons and other crafts to people who follow him or have heard his story. You can harness these same forces to impact the behavior of others, as Tom Sosnoff did. In 2011, after a successful career, first as a market maker.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.